Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Arena of Valor on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Arena of Valor and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Arena of Valor. So without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else my friends, to get started we need to launch our main browser. We have here the one we use by default. Let's continue, going to this URL that I have highlighted in green color. Now, you are able to discover on the screen. There is no need to type anything, simply because I provided a clickable link in the video description and the first main comment. We ended up on this page on the internet site of Usitility, in which we find here an in-depth explanation on the way to download and install Arena of Valor on laptop or computer. We search lower a little bit and mouse click on the download game on PC button. After clicking on that link, we get to the site of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we are going to run to enjoy the game Arena of Valor on our PC. It is now obvious that we get a number of pros of running this emulator. So we are on the way to proceed to download the Arena of Valor by simply clicking on this button play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green color. Next step is clicking on it. Of course, the download starts and ends immediately. Voila! Here is located the download. It is a file we have to execute. What we have to do now is to launch the executable file. Okay, then we have to click on this file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to allow changes to the system. We clicked yes. I minimize the web browser to view the installation software significantly better. The installation software is pretty simple. It includes a couple of choices, install, and setup path. I will talk about what setup path really does. We only simply click on it, and therefore we discover that we have now here the path in which the emulator is going to be set up. If we have to change this folder we have got to click on that browse button, and now we decide on another directory and install the emulator specifically where we like. To keep it simple, just keep it as it is. Then, I click on back. Therefore I just click on install. Fantastic. The install begins and it is going to commence in the download of all these megabytes which are shown on our screen. Once you save it on your machine, it could be a little more or less MB. The data transfer rate could go at a higher speed or slower, subject to your connection and according to the speed capacity of the emulator servers. Today they're running superbly fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At present, the emulator has actually been launched on autopilot. As you can discover, at the bottom of the screen, there's a progress bar which will fill up and once it comes to the end, the emulator can be started for the first time. Indeed, the emulator is already launched, there for the first time. Before we keep going, as can be seen, it made a couple of software icons there on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks icon is definitely the only one we're focused on. Anytime we need to operate Arena of Valor on our laptop or computer, we twice click this specific software icon and consequently start the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Shall we make the following step, which is actually a requirement, and this is to begin to browse the Google Play Store. And we are going to mouse click on Play Store. As you can view the Google Play is presented. Right here we have got to log on. So now the moment we are right here, we must definitely execute this next step that is imperative. Therefore simply click on, sign in. Presently it announces, checking info. It may occasionally get blocked in, checking info, that's why it fails to move ahead. In this case, you should try to connect to your account after a couple of hours it's going to most probably be repaired. At this time we shall insert our email address and password. The email address is required to be a Gmail email as well as its matching password. As an example you could use the same email you are using at this time in your own YouTube account. Then I am going to type my information and I'll return after I have completed it. Voila, information inserted. Find out Google welcoming us and supplying us their twos. We will approve them all by just hitting, I agree. Following that, it allows us to back up to the Google Cloud. You might let it select it, and this will create a backup of your data files on this device to Google Drive. I won't select it, you do what you want. We mouse click on accept. Google Play, formerly Android Market, is started automatically and on autopilot. To set up the application, we are required to go to the Android emulator desktop by simply clicking on the icon marked green colored. At present that we are exploring the desktop of this emulator for Android, we notice that we find there the install game option. We then click on this button. Listed here we access to the video game. How about we just click now on the install choice that I'm showing now in green color. That click will initiate the setup. Right now it would download on your laptop or computer and set up the game. It could take quite some time, or perhaps it might possibly be extremely fast. It again all relies upon on the internet access. This has as of now completed installing. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by simply clicking this particular option that I'm emphasizing in green, that allows you to launch Arena of Valor for the first time. You are presently on the emulator desktop, and therefore we are preparing to just click the new Arena of Valor app icon that was provided. Your Android game is launched for the first time. So there we end up with it. I can also click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I have to talk about the volume level of that emulator. It's right here. We use the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume. This manner we do not use the Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of your emulator. And also to appreciate the experience to the max, we should switch on the large monitor, for which we have two options. This one is simply the first one. We mouse click on this particular app icon which I am identifying in green color. Thus the display screen is maximized, coming with one border on top, one on the right side and one at the bottom. Granted that we like to experience the app using all the screen, we select that icon. And we'd at present be experiencing and enjoying the Android game in 100% screen function. To leave the 100% screen functionality, just click the F11 key. And additionally we would definitely at present play in regular display screen setting. At present, I am ready to present you the keys mapping that is certainly rather appealing. That strategy we definitely will be capable to utilize the game application much more easily. The first task is to click this app icon. It's now time to get the appropriate controls. I'll go ahead and let the default settings, though if you plan to modify it, you may well achieve it with no problem. Obviously, the emulator is absolutely in our language. In certain cases it occurs that your emulator is presented in the wrong language, for instance, in Japanese. And thus to set it up in the correct language we browse here to the cogwheel. And thus right here inside of various other controls, we just click the language drop down. We may very well decide on the language we prefer, Italian, Mandarin, and so on. Once the language is determined, we should save, the emulator would reboot, as well as the game app, next time we run it, will as well be in the specified language. So now, you will find another element that we need to take into consideration, and this is that we will get an email telling that a completely new electronic device has been linked to our Google account. It will definitely ask us if we are the individuals who have associated with that device. Absolutely, we must not be troubled, as the emulator is acting as an Google Android electronic device. So you can identify which electronic device is currently being emulated, we go right here, to the cogwheel and we then click on it. Let's browse here to that model, choice. And there we observe that the emulator is simulating a Samsung mobile. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it guys, so much for that video tutorial. I sincerely hope you appreciated it, especially that you thought it was informative. If that is so, offer it a great thumb up, subscribe, and if you have feedback, requests or suggestions, let them in the comment field down below. You could also leave comments on my Twitch channel, I conduct live streams every once in a while, you have it listed below in the video description and in the very first pinned comment. Simply click any of those online videos which are usually appearing on the computer screen and see you in the upcoming video game videos. Bye.